have a beer with Duncan, because Duncan's been late.
There you go. That's the original version, a little vinyl, which I've got here, and done by a bloke called, written by a bloke and sung by a bloke called Pat Alexander, who used to work here at the ABC in the, as the boss of the mailroom, and he's on the line. Good morning, Pat. How are you?
G'day, Ian. How are you, sir?
I'm good, thanks. A blast from the past. Well, a blast from the past from, for all of us, but probably not. Tell me, when did you write the song, Pat?
Wrote it in 1974-5. And sent it to Slim in October 1980.
You originally wrote it for Colin, is that right, Coljoy?
Well, I just wrote it, and I showed it to Colin. I had a songwriting agreement with Colin and Kevin. I found out the other day, a little bit of trivia, you were in the Joy Boys.
Just a little bit. Yeah, I was, yeah.
I didn't know that, but that's right. They got it first, and then we recorded it in the mailroom. You know, with this very talented musicians in the ABC mailroom, I tell you.
Yeah, well, that's when we used to do all sorts of things at the ABC.
That's right.
Now we're a news gathering organisation.
Whatever. Yes, well, Mike Broadhurst interviewed me, and you produced the show. That was November, December, when the song was screaming up the charts.
That was in about 1980, was it? Something like that.
In November, December 1980, that's right. You must have taken over soon after that.
Yeah, a year or so after that, a couple of years after that, end of 81, I think it was, Pat. So, and Pat, where you live in Wagga, is that right?
We live in Bathurst now. We've recently moved to Bathurst from Wagga. Mm.
And now tell me a few things. The Colin and the Kevin, was Coljoy and Kevin was Kevin Jacobson?
Of course they were. I was trying to promote the song by putting them in there. That's right.
And who's Bob?
Bob was Bob Hawke. The whole idea of having the little custom pressing done was a song called the Bob Hawke song that I thought would take over the whole Southern Hemisphere, but didn't.
That's the one on the other side of the... Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly. It was Malcolm T. Elliott on 2KY who turned the thing over and played the other side.
I see.
This is my recording before Slim got hold of it.
I see.
And Malcolm Elliott was very cranky when EMI gave Slim Dusty's version to John Laws and not to him.
Well, that's what'll happen. Those sort of things will happen.
That's right.
Yeah, John Laws was the king of radio in those days, wasn't he?
He played it 11 times on the first morning, November 1980, and that's what really launched it. Amazing.
My next guest is shaking his head now. He just wishes his songs could get played 11 times in the one morning, but just that sort of thing doesn't happen anymore. That was Lawsy, wasn't it?
Well, it was, and it was Lawsy at his top. You know, at Christmas he told me, "I'm not playing anymore." You know, this is after 6 weeks. See, he didn't have to play it anymore. Yeah. It was the nation's number one song in February 1981.
I'll say, and people still remember it. And Duncan, who was Duncan, of course?
Well, I was a very unsuccessful life insurance salesman, and I was knocking on factory office doors at St. Peter's and knocked on his door, and he invited me in politely enough. He said, "We'll go around and talk about it in the pub," and the pub was a short stone's throw from where his factory was. It was the Town and Country Hotel at St. Peter's.
Mm.
And so I love to have a beer with Duncan in the Town and Country where the atmosphere is great.
And Patrick, is that you?
Of course. I have to get in there somewhere. but it was really lovely. You know, going home in the car after no breathalyzers in those days. And going home in the car, the whole thing came to me, you know, that one verse, and it was really, and I've been told that it somehow miraculously captures the character of Australian mateship. God knows how that happens. I haven't the faintest idea.
Well, you know, it's just, I'll talk to my guest, Don Walker, in a minute. He's written lots of wonderful songs, hit songs, and, you know, for Jimmy Barnes and whatever.
Yeah,
but the long distance, the loneliness of the long distance songwriter, it's a tough gig writing songs, isn't it?
And, yeah, g'day, Don. Yeah, well, I'm not a performer. I've never done the hard yards, you know. I just sit back and enjoy it.
You never went on tour on the strength of Duncan, Pat. Is that what you're saying?
No. Actually, he died very shortly after the song was a hit. He died of a heart attack.
Mm.
Sadly, I do not know whether or not his life was insured.
Well,
I know that I didn't sell him a policy.
P- Pat, nice to talk. Nice to catch up with you. Nice to know where you're living now. Last time I heard of you, you were in Wagga. You moved. Why did you move to Bathurst from Wagga?
Oh, it's all family. Yeah. Yes, with our life, it's all family. That's what it's all about, yeah.
All right, mate. Nice to talk to you, Pat. We'll catch up sometime. I'll see you in Bathurst.
And don't mention the carrot cake, all right?
Why is that?
Oh, I've never known anybody go on so much about a carrot cake.
Oh, mate, you didn't taste the carrot cake.
No, I didn't. That's right.
Good on you, Pat.
Okay, lovely. Nice, thanks for ringing.
Nice to talk to you. Pleasure.
Thanks for doing that.
Bye.
Okay, bye.